Yes, welcome back. So we were discussing about unit 4 on the axial and radial flow turbines under for the course namely analysis and design and analysis of turbo machines. So we were discussing about the design aspects in the last session of an impulse flow axial turbine. So these are the things we have seen. So we have defined the blade efficiency, speed ratio and flow coefficients. So let us now further continue the same topic. Okay, so next parameter for design is the stage loading coefficient. So stage loading coefficient is defined as the ratio of the actual blade work. So actual blade work, you know, it is got or obtained from the Euler's equation, from the concept of velocity triangle. So that is the blade work, actual blade work, to the maximum blade work. Okay, so here we are talking about only the blade work. Okay, so what is the actual blade work? It is VW1 minus VW2 into U. So it can be also plus or minus, so depending upon the angle. So we have discussed in the last class, depending upon the value of beta, this may be minus or plus. Okay, so for beta less than 90, it will be plus, or beta greater than 90, it will be minus. Okay, so this is the actual work, and the ideal blade work or the maximum blade work can be represented as U square, where U is the blade speed. So that is the maximum work per kg, that is important, per kg of the fluid, it is U squared, it is the maximum blade work possible. Okay, so this ratio, so this we are talking about the blade only. Okay, so what is the work given by the blade, actual work given by the blade, to what is the maximum possible work that can be obtained from the blade. So it is a function of U square. Okay, so that ratio, actual by the square of the blade, is known as stage loading coefficient, given by the symbol psi. Okay, psi is equal to W by U square. So these are all performance parameters. So in the previous session we have discussed the flow coefficient and the speed ratio, etc. Okay, apart from the blade efficiency or utilization factor. Now further, okay, if you analyze, so our thing is a design and analysis of turbo machines. So if you want to further analysis the performance of the axial flow impulse turbines, okay, from the velocity triangle, from the outlet triangle, so the blade work can be represented, okay, from Euler's equation by any one of these three equations. Okay, so we have discussed in depth. Okay, so we have discussed at large these differences. You can notice here beta greater than 90. Okay, so here the whirl component will be in the direction of blade. Okay, the whirl component at outlet will be in the direction of blade, so there we'll be using my negative sign. Whereas for beta less than 90, that is the flow angle at outlet, okay, if it happens to be less than 90, the direction of the whirl component will be in the opposite direction of the blade speed. So you have minus of minus coming into picture here, so you have a positive sign. And the third one, radial outlet flow, okay, so where the flow angle, so is going to be 90 degree, the case of maximum efficiency. So VW2, the whirl, there is no whirl component, no. So if it is 90, okay, there is no whirl component outlet, so this becomes 0, so the blade work will be equal to VW1 into U. So you can see here, so basically it is a product of velocity. Okay, blade work per kg, it is a product of velocity, namely product of, say, the difference in the whirl component of the velocity into the blade velocity. So only for maximum blade work we are considering U square. Okay, for maximum we are, so it is a basically the square of velocity. So here, okay, for the generalized Euler's equation can be now, so we are moving one step further. So the generalized form, so far we were discussing Euler's equation simply as m dot into VW1 minus VW2 into U. Okay, so in general can be plus or minus, in general can be plus or minus depending upon the flow condition at outlet, beta value, it can be either plus or minus, and the reasons we have given above. Okay, so it is evident that for maximum blade work, okay, so if you want to have maximum blade work, so you want to receive maximum blade work, then obviously beta should be less than 90. then only you have a negative positive side. So you are adding two quantities, so blade work is more. If it is the beta greater than 90, you see you are subtracting some value from the initial value, so you'll be having lesser what you call as the blade work. Okay, so for maximum blade work, beta should be less than 90. It is for maximum blade work, mind it, maximum blade work what we can have is by reducing the angle beta less than 90. Hence this design is usually preferred. So in most of the axial flow machine, impulse machine, you will be having this condition. You will be having this condition, that is beta less than 90, the flow angle at outlet less than 90. Okay, for a turbine, that is also one of the important design aspect of an axial flow impulse machine. So next one, okay, is the blade work. Okay, so how we can express the blade work? Okay, so we have previously expressed blade work in terms of whirl velocity component, VW1, VW2. So just before we have seen, you can see here, so blade work has been expressed in terms of whirl component and the blade velocities. Okay, so now in terms of absolute velocity, okay, in terms of absolute velocity, which means the velocity of the fluid V1, V2, and in terms of the relative velocity, that is VR1, VR2. So when it approaches the blade, okay, and it moves through the blade, it will have some relative velocity component. So in terms of relative velocity and the blade velocity and the blade velocity, so get the difference. Previously we have expressed blade work in terms of whirl velocity and blade velocity. So this expression, okay, so all these expressions were used for finding the blade work in terms of whirl component and the blade speed, whirl component. Okay, now we can, it is also possible to express the blade work in terms of absolute, relative and the blade speed. Okay, so absolute we used to have V1, V2, relative we used to have VR1, VR2, blade you used to have U1, U2 if it is not an axial machine. If it is radial, U1, U2. If it is axial, U1 is equal to U2, so generalized you can have U. Okay, so my idea is to express blade work in terms of these three components of velocity. So we are going to use simple trigonometric basics of trigonometry, okay, and we will apply this for the inlet and outlet triangles, and we can deduce these equations, very simple things, okay, very basic of elementary trigonometry equations. So V1 square is equal to VW1 square plus VF1 square. So this is a bigger triangle. So V1 square is equal to VW1 square plus VF1 square. That is okay, fine. Then V1 squared can also be written as VW1 square. Okay, you can see here VW1 written instead of VF1. Okay, the flow velocity at inlet. So you can have a smaller triangle. So you can use the law of similar triangle concept. So VF is constant for both the triangles. Okay, so VF1 can now be written as VR1 square minus this quantity, okay, this distance for a smaller triangle. So how much it is? VW1 minus U, VW1 minus U the whole square. So V1 square minus U minus VW1, this quantity, this distance alone, okay, that I have represented here. Entire thing raised to the power of 2, okay. And you can expand this a minus b whole square, you can expand this, okay, and you can cancel out, and finally you will be having this expression. V1 square is equal to VR1 square minus U square plus 2VW1U. Okay, fine. Now VW1 into U can be expressed in terms of, okay, the you rearrange this. So it is V1 square by 2 minus VR1 square by 2 plus U square by. Similarly, from outlet triangles, it is possible. So we are going to apply again the trigonometric relations at outlet triangle. So you have the two triangles, loft similar triangles. One is the bigger triangle and other one is the smaller triangle. There again, VF2, the flow velocity at outlet is constant. If you apply the same thing, you will end up with this equation. Okay, so that is VW2U. So we are talking about the outer triangle. So VW2U. So note that U is constant here. The reason is it is an axial flow machine. Okay, and if it is not axial, you can very well put this as U1. Here you can put U2. Nothing wrong. So we will discuss the same thing when you discuss about the radial flow turbines. Okay, since it is axial, I have maintained as U. Okay, and the outlet you can see V2 square minus VR2 square by 2 plus U square. Okay, so I have got the product of this velocity at inlet wall component into U and the product of inlet wall component into U. Okay, as this in terms of absolute, relative, and the blade speed. So basically we want to have the blade work in terms of VW1 plus or minus VW2. Okay, so you can see here. So that is the concept. Okay, so this is the general blade work VW1 U1 minus VW2 U2. So I have written here the general generalized form. Okay, so it is not for an axial flow, it is for radial flow. So I have changed that U as U1 U2. VW1 U1 minus VW2 is equal to, you can subtract these two equations, okay, this term minus this term. Okay, so you can accordingly you can have this final format. Okay, this equation you can have. Okay, so this equation is a very important equation which gives you an idea about the total blade work. Okay, how it can be splitted in terms of the changes in the absolute velocity, relative velocity, and the blade velocity. You can see here, so the blade work comes from the change in absolute velocity, it comes from the changes in relative velocity, it comes from the changes in the blade speed also. Okay, and note that except this absolute velocity and blade velocity, relative velocity is having VR2 square minus VR1, final minus initial. What is the reason? So this VR2 happens to be more whenever there is some pressure drop. Okay, so when the fluid moves in a blade, its pressure decreases and velocity will increase. So in terms of for example, if you consider reaction machines, this second term will appear. Okay, so a further insight to this is the total work is going to be from the change in absolute kinetic energy due to the pressure term, second one is due to the pressure term, and the third term is due to the changes in the entry and exit. Okay, due to the radius effect. Okay, how much of energy is being changed, that is the meaning of this. So previous Euler's equation doesn't give this, Euler equation doesn't give this idea. It simply gives you VW1 plus or minus VW2 into U. Okay, it is taking into account only the whirl component. That is the component which is responsible for the rotation, which has the tendency to rotate. So the tangential component you have taken. Whereas this is the equation which we have derived now, okay, it is in terms of the changes in the kinetic energy. How much of kinetic energy is being utilized from the fluid? That is getting reflected. And how much of relative energy change is there? So this is this can be correlated to the pressure drop. So whenever there is some pressure drop, there will be some changes in relative velocity. So in for impulse machine, I have told you VR1 is equal to VR2. So there is no pressure drop. So VR1 is equal to VR2. You can see here in design aspects, we have taken the relative velocity is remaining constant. VR1 is equal to VR2, which means in impulse machine, this will not have a role. Okay, this change in relative velocity will not have a role in the blade work. That is the meaning. Okay, and the third one is this change in the diameter effect. U1 is pi d1 n by 60 and U2 is pi d2 n by 60. So whenever the fluid enters and leaves at different elevations from the axis of the shaft, so you have some diameter effect. Say for example, radial flow machine, it enters at inner radii, leaves at outer radii. So there is some diameter change, position change. Okay, so that will come into picture. So the sum of these three, that is what we have given here, blade work in terms of absolute velocity, relative velocity, and blade velocities. Okay, and particular for this topic, for an axial flow impulse turbine, so it is axial flow, so we will not have this last component. U1 must be equal to U2, so it will cancel out, and now it is an impulse turbine, which means there is no effect of the second term also. So the blade work can also be expressed as V1 square minus V2 square divided by 2. Okay, so this is only for an axial flow impulse machine. So So next topic. So we are simply making making what you call as the various forms, okay, in which the expressions can be expressed. Okay, very simple thing. Don't get panic. It is very simple. We are simply rearranging the equations, okay, in different forms. That's all. So the third one is blade work. Again, blade work in terms of flow angles and blade angles. The fluid will have some angle at inlet and outlet. Namely, we are having alpha, beta, and blade angles we are having theta and phi. Okay, at inlet and outlet. So blade work can also be expressed in terms of these angles. These angles. Okay. So again, I have taken the Euler equation. I have written here the Euler equation, trigonometry equation relation use. Okay. So Vw1 plus Vw2. Okay. I have used for maximum work the plus sign here. So Vw1 plus Vw2 is equal to, note here, it is Vf1 cot alpha divided by Vf2 cot beta. So cot is inverse of tan, okay, which means this is cos alpha by sin alpha and this is cos beta by sin beta. So you can see here how I want Vw1. I will explain one for this single thing. Vw1 I want. Okay, so Vf1 by Vw1, if you take this bigger triangle, Vf1 by Vw1 will be equal to tan alpha. Okay, now I want Vw1, so you cross multiply, it becomes Vf1 by tan alpha is equal to Vw1. Okay, so I have here 1 by tan alpha. So for simplicity, I have used that 1 by tan alpha as cot alpha. So different books use different notations. I'll come to that later. So according to my diagram, okay, it is going to be cot alpha and cot beta. Okay, similarly you can use here for outlet. Okay, Vw2 is here. Okay, so then for this opposite side is Vf2. So Vf2 divided by Vw2 will be equal to tan beta. I want Vw2. Cross multiply, then it become Vf2 divided by tan beta is equal to Vw2. So 1 by tan beta is equal to cot beta. So that is how we are getting this value, this expression. So this is in terms of fluid angle. Similarly, you can express this in terms of blade angles also. Okay. Now the other thing is the Vf1 must be equal to Vf2. Vf1 must be equal to Vf2. This is an important design aspects. Earlier we have discussed this also. What is the reason? The reason is we want to maintain zero axial velocity, not to have zero axial thrust. Okay, not to avoid vibrations, prevent vibrations. So the axial force must be same at inlet and outlet of the blade. So Vf1 must be equal to Vf2. That is another important design criteria. So I can remove this Vf1 and Vf2 and make it as common as simply Vf. And this is the reason we have defined the flow coefficient as simply Vf by U. You can see another parameter, Vf by U. Flow coefficient we have defined as simply Vf by U. We are not putting Vf1 by U or Vf2 by U. Okay, the reason is it is going to be constant. There is no point in saying Vf1, Vf2. Okay, for zero, unless otherwise mentioned. We are assuming all those things. But in practical application, there may be some slight difference between the inlet and outlet axial force, which will cause some vibration. Which is unavoidable. Okay, so theoretically we are assuming the axial velocities are same. So finally, in terms of fluid angle, you can have like this. Okay, into U. Okay, so because the Euler equation is having Vw1 plus Vw2 into U, so you have the U component coming here. You have U component coming here. So this is in terms of fluid angle. Similarly, you can go for blade angles also. Okay, so blade angles also you can have. So you can see instead of blade flow angle, here you have blade angle theta and phi, the same principle. Okay, various forms, that's all. You see all these are worked on. And another important thing here, this is very very important. So here we have marked the angle for drawing the inlet and outlet velocity triangle. What we have done is we have taken the angle with respect to the tangential direction. Okay, so you can see here, this is the tangential direction. So this is the moving blade, and the rotor will be something like this. Shaft will be like this. Okay, shaft will be perpendicular to the plane of paper. Okay, and this component, this direction is the tangential direction. It is acting over the rotor, tangential component. So in otherwise, we can simply say horizontal. When I say horizontal, it is in the plane of paper. For us, it is the plane of paper. Okay, or plane of board. Okay, as we are taking on online, we can say it is the your screen, plane of screen. Okay, so in this screen, it is horizontal direction, but it is not horizontal. We should not say horizontal. Okay, it is tangential. That is the correct technical term. For understanding, we can say horizontal with respect to horizontal. Okay, that so we have taken angle with respect to horizontal. Some books will take the angle with respect to the axial direction, that is vertical to the plane of paper. So I have told the axis is going to be in this direction, rotor is going to be in this direction. So you have the axis in this direction. Okay, so only we are having the flow velocity or axial velocity. Okay, so sometimes the angles will be made with respect to the axial direction, not the tangential direction. That is, so they will mark the angle here. So this angle is with respect to the axial direction or vertical to the plane of paper. Okay, and the angle made by the absolute is from here to here. Similarly, you can have at the outlet. Instead of marking from with respect to the tangential direction, you can mark the angle with respect to the axial direction. Okay, so they have their own convenience. So different other use different notations. So what happens then? Okay, you can see here this 90 minus, okay, because it is right angle triangle, the sum of three angles is 180. Okay, so you can have this as 190 minus. So this is 90. So this is alpha. So this I want to find, this angle, say for example I want to find, then 180 degree must be equal to alpha plus 90 plus this angle. So on rearranging, already 90 is here, 180 is there, so you have 90 minus alpha. So if I want to express in the axial direction, this alpha can be 90 minus alpha, and similarly here it is 90 minus theta, and so on. Here if I want to have the flow angle at outlet, it is going to be 90 minus beta. The blade angle at outlet is going to be 90 minus phi at outlet. Okay, likewise it can change. So what you can say here is 90 minus, if you put, so you know 90 is coming here by trigonometry concepts, this card becomes tan. In some books they will be using like this, tan alpha, tan beta, tan theta and tan phi. So this is only for understanding, I am telling you, don't get confused. You follow either one methodology of marking the angle, either with reference to tangential direction or with reference to the axial direction. But you must be clear. Okay. And the angles are same. How I have put like this is sum of the fluid angles with respect to cart and the sum of the blade angles with respect to cart, okay, equal. How it is equal? Because both are representing the work done. You can see here, this is the work done equation and this is the work done equation. Both work done should be equal. We are talking about the blade work. So I can say that Vf remaining constant, U will cancel. So cot alpha plus cot beta must be equal to cot theta plus cot phi. So that is what we have indicated here. Okay. So we have discussed the blade work, Euler equation. Then we have discussed blade work in terms of absolute velocity, relative velocity and the blade speed. We have discussed the blade velocity in terms of fluid angle and the blade angle. Next one is in terms of stagnation enthalpy. So we have defined the stagnation state and stagnation enthalpy. Okay, the total enthalpy. So in turbo machines, velocities are considerable at inlet and outlet. So it is better to use stagnation properties instead of static properties. So the blade work can be given as W is equal to the enthalpy, stagnation enthalpy drop. Stagnation enthalpy drop. What is the stagnation enthalpy drop? So we know H1 minus H2 or H1 minus H3, whatever the notation we follow, we used to put some enthalpy drop in the turbine. That is the blade work. Here it is stagnation enthalpy. So it is delta H naught, the difference. Okay, so in terms of temperature, if you want to express it, is Cp into dt. Okay, so the change in temperature, so you can express delta H naught as delta T naught in terms of temperature. Okay, so to summarize, so these are the things we have seen so far. Okay, same blade work can be expressed first in terms of Euler equation, second in terms of absolute velocity, blade work and relative velocity. Relative velocity and blade work are not shown here. The reason here, for axial and impulse machine, it will not come here. Okay, those two terms will not appear here. Then the blade work in terms of purely the flow angle, alpha and beta is shown. Okay, so for my terminology, I have cot. So if the angles are marked with reference to axial direction, then the cot will become tan alpha, because you have 90 minus alpha coming there and everywhere for the angles. So the all the cot terms will be made as tan. Okay. Similarly, in terms of blade angles at inlet and outlet, okay, you have the two equations. Okay, these equations. Then in terms of stagnation enthalpy. Okay. So while doing problems, you must be very careful. Okay, we cannot have only Euler's equation. That is important. If you don't get panic and memorize all those things, keep in mind the Euler's equation, and be aware of the trigonometry concept, the triangles. Okay, so you can as and when required. So what is the data given the problem? Whether it is the flow angle, whether it is the blade angle, whether it is the enthalpies. Okay. So from that you can get the value of the blade work. Okay, so it is a very important point, and I want to emphasize that based on the given date of the problem, we have to go for changes. Okay, in the basic Euler equation, that is the concept. So only for academic purpose, I am explaining all those things. But it is just sufficient if you have this Euler's equation and the concept of triangle. Okay, trigonometry. Okay, then everything you can make some manipulations. Okay, mathematical manipulations you can do, and you can get the values. Okay, next parameter is stage efficiency. What is stage efficiency? So stage efficiency, you know, it is the ratio between the actual enthalpy drop to isentropic enthalpy drop. We have discussed in unit 1 also, while defining the efficiencies, various efficiencies. There we define this as isentropic efficiency. Now we are talking about a turbine, that to a stage, a single stage, which consists of a moving blade and stationary blade. Moving blade or stationary blade, and put together, the stationary and the moving blade is known as the stage. Okay. So instead of saying that as isentropic efficiency, we are calling here as stage efficiency. That is, for a particular turbine stage, what is the efficiency? That is all. So it is equally good to think this is an isentropic efficiency. So the actual stagnation enthalpy drop to the isentropic stagnation enthalpy drop is the stage efficiency. So here you can have different expressions being given. One in terms of the actual quantity, temperature drop, stagnation enthalpy drop. This is the stagnation enthalpy drop in an ideal process. Okay, this equation, I have taken that temperature T naught 1, because we will be always having this initial conditions. Okay, in the problem also they will give the initial conditions. So Cp T naught 1 into T naught 2 S by T naught 1. So here you have the temperature ratio during an isentropic process. So this temperature ratio can be expressed in terms of pressure ratio. In terms of pressure ratio, P naught 1 by P naught 1 into gamma minus 1 by gamma. So if the problem is directly given with this data, so I cannot use this straight away. Okay, so I will be using this this one, because initial pressure stagnation temperature is given and the pressure ratio is given. So I will use this expression to find delta H naught S. Okay, so that is the reason why I have given these expressions. So have a concept, understand the idea that the stage efficiency is nothing but the enthalpy drop, actual enthalpy drop in terms of stagnation property to the isentropic stagnation enthalpy drop. That is the stage efficiency. Okay, put together the stationary blade and the moving blade. Okay, that is the stage. So I will stop here. Okay, we shall continue in the next session about the blade efficiencies. Okay, before that, so I would like to summarize again. So we are discussing about the axial flow turbines. So we have indicated what are the basic things of an axial flow turbine. Then we have talked about the axial impulse flow turbine. Okay, how the arrangement will be, what happens to pressure, velocity, and the velocity triangles, the location of the nozzle, moving blade. So the distance in between, we have exaggerated here, and we have shown the velocity triangles. And we have we must be familiar with all the quantities here in the velocity triangle. Okay. Then the design aspects, several design aspects we have discussed. Okay. Then the blade work. Okay. Several forms of blade work. So basically, starting from this Euler's equation, then we move to the absolute quantity, relative quantity, velocity quantity. Then in terms of blade angles and flow angles, then in terms of stagnation enthalpy you can express, all those things we have discussed. And based on this, once if you get the actual work, okay, you can go for stage efficiency, okay, which is the actual work divided by the stagnation, isentropic stagnation enthalpy drop you can have. That is a static. Next is blade efficiency. Blade efficiency is nothing but the ratio between the blade work, that is W is here, to the input what we are supplying. It is the fluid energy. Okay, it is in the form of kinetic energy for impulse machine. So that we shall discuss in the next session. So thank you for watching. Okay, we shall meet in the next session. Thank you.